And welcome to Dark Souls 2. Now this is the Scholar of the First Stead. Now when it comes to the DLC, I will be doing every single boss of Dark Souls 2 and 3. Dark Souls 1, I just wanted to get it done and over it just because of that fucking fight that took me 5 fucking parts. I still have to do all the rest of the bosses of the DLC, however. But I'm going to do that on a live stream if I ever get there again, which I probably will because I know what the hell I'm doing now. But whenever we play Dark Souls 2, I do have a I fucking don't know, jackass. Servers, sleeping information. Okay, so we're gonna start a new game. This is Dark Souls 2. Now this is a prequel to Dark Souls 1. Because in the story-based game, it goes Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 1, and then Dark Souls 3. Dark Souls 1 and 2 are switch swap when it comes to the story. That's why this game is a little bit different. We're going to start a new game. However, we don't get to create a character right off the bat, actually.
Perhaps you've seen it. Maybe in a dream.
Well, the story. I know this game is a more story driven as well. It's at least a little more story in this game. Which is perfect. With- hey, it's raining! Yes! Best game ever!
A place where souls may mend your ailing mind.
I'm gonna go for a strength build again.
You will lose everything. Once branded. The symbol of the curse. An augur of darkness. Your past, your future, your very light.
Why is your fucking face melting? That's fucking creepy as shit.
None will have meaning, and you won't even care. By then, you'll be something other than human.
Hey, a spider.
A thing that feeds on souls. A hollow.
Yeah, we were hollow in the first game, but they didn't really tell you.
Long ago, in a walled-off land far to the north, a great king built a great kingdom. I believe they called it Dranglake. Perhaps you're familiar. No, how could you be? But one day, you will stand before its decrepit gate without really knowing why.
I know why, because this game is fucking creepy. Get fucking creepy out, lady! Thank you, get off the fucking screen, I don't want to see you again!
Thank you.
There's our character. So I gave my sister my 3DS. Because I don't use it. I really don't. I mean, seriously, I don't even play my 3DS. So I gave it to my sister. What's the point? I need to get a customized 3DS to record stuff. Now I don't have the fucking brain to do that. So that's why I just gave it to her. I will be doing 3DS games at some point, but my guy drew a... I got... Whoa! Fire! Giant fucking bull.
After time.
Are we gonna jump into it? Well, that guy's probably got a concussion because his eyes just fucking.
For that is your fate.
My fate
of the
what?
Fate of the cursed.
So we're just gonna jump into a whirlpool that we don't know what's gonna happen. Are you just... What the fuck is this? Well, I don't know. So this is Dark Souls 2, by the way. So, before I start saying stuff, this will be on the same path as Gears of War 2. So here's what we're gonna be doing. When we do Gears of War 3, I'm going to be trying to get to Gears of Dark Souls 3 and also Mario Bros. 3 at the same time. Because it's all the sequel games. So I've already done Mario Bros. 1 and 2 in the Lost Levels, which, by the way, look at my insanity when I try to save state because I'm using a fucking console that you can save state anywhere you go! And I don't edit out the shit because it's funnier that way. Although I should have, but no. If I can cheat, I will cheat. Sorry. Alright, so this is Dark Souls. Now, you can't create your own character just yet, because you're pretty much hollow at this point. However, this is the only game where if you die too many times, you lose your hair and everything. These guys are not hostile as long as you don't attack them. So, be on the wary. We do not want to go that way, because I don't want to die. Because I know there's a monster, and I have no fucking weapon at this point. However, we can get this one. There we go, soaking stuff. We're going to be playing Dark Souls 2 at some point. So when it comes to the bosses that I missed on Dark Souls 1, I will be doing a live stream on that game, so I will be playing Dark Souls 1. I will be playing Dark Souls 1 until I get to the DLC. Because I know I'm missing a lot of DLC bosses. So, yeah. I'm going to beat up the bosses that I missed. And we have to get to the boss fight that I could not get to. So, yeah. But I'm not going to do a New Game Plus because I'm having difficulty beating a simple boss, which pisses me off. But we'll get to that when we get to that. I'm also playing Elden Ring with it on Helly's channel.
Oh my, your face.
My face?
Of the curse.
These ladies are fucking hot it's as hell. The lady that's standing up is hot!
Dead has come to play.
These ladies are blind, I believe. That's what my brother said.
All the ones like you. You spoke to that kind old dear, didn't you? You're finished. You'll go hollow. Yes, you'll become one of them.
Yes, we're dead.
Hollows prey upon men. Feast upon their souls.
You saw his ass, she's got big boobs!
This is the fate.
The girl that just put the table, the cup on the table. She's got some good hips. Yo, ladies,
what
look
is
right
your
there.
Name?
My name? Alright, hold on. So, if you must remember, the first game we had Fascinations Channel. And we're going to be doing Fascinations Channel is a YouTuber that's one of my closest friends. You should subscribe to her. She doesn't upload as much because she's too damn busy. But she's one of my closest friends and I love her to death as a friend. But since she was we named her in the first playthrough of Dark... She was the main character of the first Dark Souls, so we're going to continue that theory. And she's also going to be playing as, she's also going to be, we're also going to name Fascinatious. Is that how you spell her name, or am I missing a letter? No, I'm not. Okay. So, she's going to be the main, this character, we're, all Dark Souls games, Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3, we're going to be naming Fascinatious Channel. Because since she was named for the first game, we're gonna name her the second and third game as well. So that's what we're gonna do, yes.
At least you know your own name.
Yeah, I know my own name, but I can't fucking spell it!
Here's your reward for sharing. It's a human effigy.
Yes.
Take a closer look. Who do you think it's supposed to be?
Me, Fascinatious.
Think back, deep into your past.
My past? I was a kid!
Yes, it's an effigy of you.
Yes. So, we didn't, they didn't really tell you what. They didn't tell you, were we abandoned? No, we weren't. I think we were, thief. Warrior knight. Well, warrior gets a shield. Knight sword. Oh shit. I don't know what I should use! Well, we were abandoned the last time, but I don't want to use a fucking axe. I look like a fucking tool. I'm not a sorcerer, so. What is the most strength? Well, warrior has the most strength. But we're gonna be a knight this time. A dying human effigy is a life ring. Bonfire sister. Toss it into the bonfire to raise the strength nearby foes. Oh, that is really interesting. Petrified lump. Healing wares. I don't think I need healing wares. That thing, we used that a couple times in the first game, but we didn't use it that much. Put you some healing effigies. Okay, body. Gender, we want female. Thank you. Build. Fascination's channel physique. We're not gonna let her have a six pack. Face. No. Dang it. We have to use the same fucking hairstyle. We gotta use the same hairstyle because that's what we did the last time, so. That looks butt fucking ugly. She's gonna have the shine gun! Gotta have at least somewhat of a pink. There we go. Advanced settings? Nah, I'm good. There we go, okay. Do I really want home? I don't know what I should have. Human entity is gonna, we can do any day. I know Seeds of Giant. From the tree of Giants, incredible. I know what that does. Petrified something. Petrified love that may be used. See, I don't know what the hell this thing is, but we're gonna use healing wires because I need all the healing I can get. So let's do this.
All people come here for the same reason. To break the curse.
Wait, what curse?
Different, I should think. Doesn't stand a chance. Well, you never know.
Stop laughing at me, bitches! You can kill these girls if you want to.
Go through the door and trot along to the kingdom.
Okay.
But remember, hold on to your souls. They're all that keep you from going hollow. Oh, I'll fool you no longer. You lose your souls. All of them. Over and over again.
Maybe you should brush your fucking teeth! Your teeth are fucking yellow, wet bitches! And welcome to Dark Souls 2. Okay, so we are knight this time around. I think the last time we were a thief, I believe. I don't know what playthrough that was. I might have to check it out. Human Institute. See, this is why. Man, the music is really fucked up. Now, there is an enemy down here, but I don't know if I can kill it, but... we'll wait and see. We might die, which we probably will at this point. There we go, so that's how you use that. Whoa, shit! Thank God I had enough time to roll. Okay, so I can hit at least... miss, bitch. Come on, bitch. Alright, we didn't die this time. That takes a lot of credit. Thank you. You got a stone ring. Nice. Oh, yeah, that's right. I can hold up my weapon twice. I forgot about that. Since we don't have a shield yet. I didn't die this time. Awesome. Oh yeah, also when you die, your health gets split in half. So, I think that was evident. So when you die in this game, your health gets cut in half. Because you're not a human anymore. Unlike the first game where if you die, you still have the same amount of health. So I think Dark Souls 2 is a lot harder because of that reason. Also, some enemies respawn, some enemies do not. Also, leveling up, you can't level up in the bonfire anymore, I do believe. So, you also gotta be careful of that. You don't get SS plots in the beginning of the game like you did in the first game. However, we can't use the fucking shield at this point. These are tutorials. You can still parry without the shield, by the way. I mean, you could do that in the first game, but... You know what? Fuck you. I'm trying to shoot something off and you're being a fucking asshole! You can still backstab too. Can't go there yet. Oh shit, I almost killed myself. Oops. That's fucking funny. We got a dagger at least. There's also a delay if it comes to attacking enemies. So you also gotta be careful. But did you drop something? Fuck you, bitch! People still play Dark Souls, and that's the fun thing about Dark Souls. Is that even though the game is like too fucking old, people still fucking play it. I can't get anything because I can't really do it, but at least I can kick this thing down. That's a bird nest, but I forget what weapon I can get. So yeah, that's my fault. But yeah. We need to get Pacific Eye. So welcome to Dark Souls 2. Now, if you must know why I'm better at this game than Dark Souls 1. Because I know what the fuck I'm doing, sort of. Why is there so many people dying over here? Whatever. The Parry King. I should be the Parry King! That's gonna be my new title. Welcome to the first land of the... Sanctions. So this is the... Yes. I like Dark Souls 2's music because it's a lot better. Because it's peaceful. Because it seems like you're in a desolate world. Also, if you look at the lore of Dark Souls games, they're all fucking dark and fucking depressing. Like, literally. Now then, you can travel to each bonfire, I believe? I think, right? Yes. So, Dark Souls 1, you have to beat... You have to go through the game for a specific point. You have to beat the handicap match between the guy with the spear and the guy with the hammer. And then once you talk with the lady with the big boobs, then you can travel to any bonfire. Well, most of them, anyway. This game, you can travel to any bonfire right from the start. However, when it comes to leveling up, you have to talk to her.
Are you the next monarch?
She is fucking hot as hell!
I'm merely a pawn of fate. Bearer of the curse. I will remain by your side till this frail hope shatters. Take this with you. May it ease your journey.
Now then, here's the problem with this lady. And I'm gonna tell you this right now.
You see the king.
I'm trying to explain something, bitch!
You made Dranglake what it once was. He who peered at the essence of the soul. King Vendrick.
Now then, when it comes to her, you can kill her. But if you kill her in this game, well, she wasn't in the first game. But if you kill her, you can't level up anymore.
Bearer of the curse, for misery will lead you to greater, stronger souls.
Uh-huh.
You will never meet the king with a soul so frail and pallid. Seek those whose names are unutterable. The four endowed with immense souls. Their souls will serve as beacons.
Uh-huh.
Once you have found them, return here to me. So that hope will not fade away. Bearer of the curse.
Bearer of the curse!
Seek souls. Larger, more powerful souls. Seek the king. That is the only way. Lest this land swallow you whole, as it has so many others.
That's dark and fucking depressing. We can only level up by using her. Alright, we want strength. We also want endurance. Endurance, strength, and index. What's this one? That's poise. We might need to use that. Intelligence. We do need to use, put up intelligence at some point. Faith, that's magic user. Intelligence, yeah. We won't be using that. We're just gonna be updating vigor in the decks, vigor, strength in the decks. We're not gonna use these three because they're about magic, so. I'm not a magic user. Thank you.
Over the hill and past the forest is the king's castle. Where a man peered straight into the essence of the soul. But whatever came of it?
She is hot as hell. What? Fuck her! Not that one. Alright, so this is... Alright. Oh yeah, you... Oh yeah, that's right. There we go. Oh yeah. Also, if you're in this menu, which says equipment and stuff like that, you can attack. So you gotta make sure you're on this level. So yeah.
Just help me open this door. I packed my tools in here, seeing it was vacant. But now somebody's gone and locked the door.
Okay, so we have to find the key. We have one SS flask. You have to get SS flask shards just to get more SS flasks. It's not like the first game where the first game you get five, you get pretty much 10 SS flags, and then the only way you could get the 10 back is by upgrading the bonfire. So pretty much if you just lit the bonfire, you get, and when you die, you get 5 SS flasks. If you power it up when you're hollow, when you're human, how do I say this? When you're human, you get to power up to get 10. There's a way to get 20, I know that. But we're gonna move this way. Cause this is the first area that I know of. And the music stops because how do you die in a fucking treasure chest? Okay. Well, at least I can roll now. So, this is Dark Souls 2, everyone. Welcome to my insanity. Now, if you must know, I'm a lot better at Dark Souls 2 because I know the mechanics more than Dark Souls 1. So it's gonna be a lot easier for me to beat this game. However, even though I said that, I still might die a lot, so just wanna let you know that. Human entities will help you out in this game more than not. Cause if you keep dying, well, here's another problem with Dark Souls 2. Shit. You're a fucking idiot. We're gonna take the safe route. Fucking buffoon! Dude, I saw you there, motherfucker. The guy's not turning around here. There we go. I saw in the corner of my eye. I never usually get these items. Now then, there is a fucking, there is a fucking bonfire over there, but we have to... Bonfire, there it is. That guy is walking and he just dies. Burn. I can burn entities. Use this item to reverse hollow. One begins to... Oh, okay. Gotcha. Well, we made it to the first bonfire. Hope you guys have a nice positive day and take fucking care, bitches!